high above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of the Happy Prince. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold. For eyes, he had two bright sapphires, and a large ruby glowed on his sword hilt. He was very much admired indeed. One night, there flew over the city a little swallow on his way south to the pyramids in Egypt. He stopped when he saw the statue on the tall column.
I will put up here for the night. It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air. I have a golden bedroom.
Just as the swallow prepared to go to sleep, a large drop of water fell on him.
What a curious thing. There's not a single cloud in the sky, and yet it's raining. The climate here in the north is really dreadful.
Then another drop fell.
What is the use of a statue if it cannot keep the rain off? I must look for a good chimney pot.
But before he had opened his wings, a third drop fell, and he looked up and saw, what did he see? The eyes of the Happy Prince were filled with tears, and tears were running down his golden cheeks.
Who are you?
I am the Happy Prince.
Why are you weeping then?
When I was alive and had a human heart, I did not know what tears were. My courtiers called me the Happy Prince, and happy indeed I was, if pleasure be happiness. Now that I am dead, I am up here so high I can see all the ugliness and all the misery of my city, and though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep.
What? Is he not solid gold?
The swallow said this to himself. He was too polite to make any personal remarks out loud.
Far away in a little street, there is a poor house. One of the windows is open, and through it I can see a woman seated at a table. Her face is thin and worn, and she has coarse red hands, all pricked by the needle, for she is a seamstress. She is embroidering passion flowers on a satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maids of honor to wear at the next court ball. In a bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill. He has a fever and is asking for oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water, so he's crying. Swallow, little swallow, will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I cannot move.
I am waited for in Egypt. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers.
Swallow, little swallow, will you not stay with me for one night and be my messenger? The boy is so thirsty and the mother is so sad.
It is very cold here, but I will stay with you for one night and be your messenger.
Thank you, little swallow.
So the swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover.
How wonderful the stars are, and how wonderful is the power of love.
I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball. I have ordered passion flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy.
He passed over the river and saw the lanterns hanging to the masts of the ships. And at last he came to the poorhouse and looked in. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed, and the mother had fallen asleep. She was so tired. In he hopped and laid the great ruby on the table beside the woman's thimble. Then the swallow flew back to the Happy Prince and told him what he had done.
It is curious, but I feel quite warm now, although it is so cold.
And that's because you have done a good action.
And the little swallow began to think, and then he fell asleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had a bath.
Tonight, I go to Egypt.
The swallow was in high spirits at the prospect. When the moon rose, he flew back to the Happy Prince.
Have you any commissions for Egypt? I'm just starting.
Swallow, will you not stay with me one night longer?
I am waited for in Egypt.
Swallow, swallow, little swallow. Far away across the city, I see a young man in a garret. He is leaning over a desk covered with papers. He's trying to finish a play for the director of the theater, but it's too cold to write anymore. There is no fire in the grate, and hunger has made him faint.
I will wait with you one night longer. Shall I take him another ruby?
Alas, I have no ruby now. My eyes are all that I have left. They are made of rare sapphires which were brought out of India 1,000 years ago. Pluck out one of them and take it to him. He will sell it to the jeweler, buy firewood, finish his play.
Dear Prince, I cannot do that.
Swallow, swallow, little swallow, do as I command you.
So the swallow plucked out the prince's eye and flew away to the student's garret. It was easy enough to get in, as there was a hole in the roof. Through this he darted and came into the room. The young man had his head buried in his hands, so he did not hear the flutter of the bird's wings. And when he looked up, he found the beautiful sapphire.
I am beginning to be appreciated. This is from some great admirer. Now I can finish my play.
The next night, the swallow flew back to the happy prince.
I am come to bid you goodbye.
Swallow, swallow, little swallow. Will you not stay with me one night longer?